My name is Mary Ann Kello at 849 Las Palas Drive. This has been very interesting, and I can see it costs so much money, and I don't blame everybody for being upset, for wondering how it's going to get paved. And I'm going to tell you one thing. The day that this took place on our street, we felt like we had our street back. I particularly feel much safer with the parents coming along and parking in front of the park to get their kids out, because when the employees were all parking there, they're coming on their lunch hour to make that hour of going to get their errands done or doing whatever else they're going to do, and they're making U-turns in the middle of the street, right, coming down fast, which we don't need any more of that, which we already have enough. So to me, this has been a big advantage. If you want to increase the fees, that's fine with me. I feel the good benefits outweigh that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right.
Good evening, City Council. My name is Sheila Tanner. I live at 855 Las Palos. And of course, over the past 10 years, I've been here listening to how we're going to make our community better. And what I just wanted to first mention, I'm curious how much detail you've had information and expertise. I know we've gotten a lot of expertise from the hospital to help us as a city understand how the parking permit works. And a lot of other cities have done it very successfully. I realize this is our first year. Living at Las Palos, if anything, our streets are, there is less crime, and nobody has put that into the picture of how much money we're actually saving. You've had Neighborhood Watch has been huge in our area, and I'm sure Steve McShane can attest to that as well. Our communities have been closer. There's a bond of making it a family unit in the area, and I think we really have to consider that. You know, I really don't know how much background you guys have from the questions that have been asked to James and what's going on. I understand that we need monies, and also with Friday furloughs, I barely ever see anybody over the park monitoring, no citations. So when I call, they say it's Friday furloughs. Why is that? There's somebody are supposed to be, somebody is supposed to be specifically focused on that, and the patrol person is supposed to be focused on that area, and there shouldn't be a policeman coming in and substituting. So I would like to know how that happened and why we would have to pay somebody this year for that to happen.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Kathleen Annerich, and I'm at 116 Salmon Drive. My family's lived in this neighborhood for 50 years. My question is for Mr. McMillan. On our side, we have a neighborhood watch that has a civilian patrol, and
okay, I need you to address us, and then we'll get.
Okay.
No, that's fine. Then we'll get the questions answered. I'm writing them down.
Okay, and I just wanted to know if the civilian patrols who go around with their little notepads and they, you know, note things, they're not supposed to be vigilantes, if they could do some of the patrol for them.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hang around, and we'll get that answered. Okay, anyone else?
Hi, I'm Leanne Battersby. I live at 829 Las Palas Drive. First of all, thank you for the godsend of cleaning up the street. It's been long overdue. I've lived there my whole life. Second, I don't think too many of the residents would mind if you had to raise the rates on the permits. What I want to know is it set in stone that we can only charge $35 for a ticket? Why not raise that price and make them pay if they're going to break the law? Thank you.
Okay, thank you. All right, anyone else?
Hello, my name is Peter Sheets, and I live on Sierra Drive. And I noticed from Mr. Serrano's presentation that I think I understood it that roughly now 100 tickets are being issued per month in the two-hour parking zone. So I wonder if we're serving our residents well in there. Recently, I went to Monterey, took my mother and my wife out to Mother's Day and parked for 2 hours at a restaurant in Monterey. You can imagine that I didn't make it back in time. And I was quite irritated that I had to pay a parking ticket, as I think these 100 people per month that we are ticketing for going to a doctor's office, maybe 2 hours is not enough time to see their doctor by the time they wait. So I want to look at it from the point of view of the resident, not as an income source. Item number two, also from his presentation, it showed that after the initial 3 months, that they were issuing about 50 tickets per month for people who parked in the area they shouldn't park. So if you calculate that going forward, that'll only be 600 tickets that we'd be issuing over the next year at $35 a ticket. That's $21,000. And of that, we're only keeping roughly less than half of that. So that would only be around $10,000, which is a much smaller number than what's in the projected estimations. Number three, I guess I would like to know what agency did the estimates for the expected citation receipts to the city of Salinas. They expected to have $175,000. We only end up with $40,000. That's being off by like 75%. That's a huge number, and really makes me very concerned about any projections being done going here or going forward. Number four on citation receipts, it shows that of 7,500 sites, only 67% have been collected so far. So do we have a chance to still get that, or is that being written off?
Okay, thank you.
I'm done. Okay.
You are.
And I'd like to know where I can bring up more of these things. Okay. I'd like to be involved. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Anyone else?
Good evening. My name is Jacqueline Anciano, and I live at 1164 Los Palos Drive. And I just have a couple of questions, Chair and Councilman. I heard Councilman Sanchez ask a question about how the cost and benefits, how it was calculated that we're over budget. And I heard Mr. Serrano say that they hadn't calculated the cost and benefits of that employee. It was only the hourly. That's what I had noted when he was making his presentation. And perhaps that's where it was over budget. But I have a couple of questions, because there are new streets that are supposed to be added. And at the time that the hospital came to us, they told us that those new streets, if they were added in, they would have to pay for their cost. So I wasn't clear if that is part of the budget for the 2011 and 2012. And then another issue is, we show that the permits, residential permits, are going to go from 2 to possibly 6. And why the fee went down, it seems to me that fee would go up. You get 2 for whatever the base price is, and if you need additional residents, that should go up. We were told that if they had a bridge club, or if there was a funeral or something like that, there were concessions that would be made for those events. But to have 6 permits, even residential, that's a lot of permits for a residence. We have found some abuse in those, in the guest permits, and there was a proposal from one of the residents relative to the guest permits that they be by street. And that was a great idea, because when someone is visiting my house, they should be parked in front of my house, not on Wilgart or Alameda. So we'd like for that to be considered. And we just really appreciate the program. It's been fabulous to get our neighborhood back. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, anyone else?
Mayor Donahue and City Council, David Sargeni, resident 21 Wilgart Way, and a resident of the city of Salinas for 36 years now. In looking at the presentation and reading the staff report last night, it very much feels to me that this was a hastily done project, the staff report and the recommendations to you this evening. I think we may need to take a step back and allow the citizens to have some input on this, because we really haven't had that. This council has taken that action many times in the past to get the input from the stakeholders, if you will, and let us try and come up with a solution. This is a very important project. I can tell you one thing, it works, and it works very well. So just to throw some numbers up there and say we're going to either have a dedicated or part-time, or we can't afford to do it, why not push it back to the stakeholders to come up with some solutions and then present that to you guys to make an educated and informed decision? Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, David. All right, anyone else? Okay, we will...
Good evening, members of council, Mayor Donahue. Matt Spiegel, resident 32 Wilgart Way. Late yesterday afternoon, I sent each of you an email. I don't know if you got it, and if you did, if you took a chance to read it. Mr. Serrano should have gotten a copy of it also. There's very specific points raised in that email, 11 points specifically, and if you aren't going to ask those 11 points to Mr. Serrano, Mr. McMillan, and if they're not going to provide answers to each of the 11 points, you shouldn't be voting on this today. Issues of abuse, cost, responsibility at the hospital, we never heard anything mentioned of a cap. It was always 100% of cost, first year. That needs to be collected. Six resident passes at decreasing cost, total recipe for abuse. The guest passes, we've talked about to Mr. Serrano repeatedly about marking those. Guest pass, if you're on Wilgart Way, your guest passes say Wilgart Way. You can easily identify when they're being abused on a street. That eliminates a lot of the legwork they have to do, makes enforcement easier, more efficient, more economical. All of these points need to be addressed. This program cannot stop. If it does, I'm gonna be here more times than you wanna see me. So the other part and the final part is the other half of the problem. If you, 12 years ago, when we first started dealing with this, had set up an assessment district for that whole medical community, started putting funds in to develop a city parking garage, just like any other business district, having funds that could be used to help offset any deficits so we could continue to have enforcement and everything else, 10 years later, we wouldn't be having this discussion. We'd have adequate parking for the hospital, adequate parking for the patients, and peace and quiet on our streets. You need to take a step now to address that other 50% part of the problem. You can't just say, the hospital's paying this, the residents have to pay that, and ignore the rest of it. All these questions need to be addressed tonight, or you shouldn't be voting on this until they are. Thank you.
Anyone else?
Marianne Warden. One of the first things when I became a traffic commissioner, I got a phone call from one of the neighborhoods over there behind the hospital. So I've been involved with this for a long, long time. I must say, I really commend these people. They have really, really worked hard, and all the groups that I have worked with in the city, they have come together to make their neighborhoods a lot safer and for their children and the rest of their families. I mean, I'm really proud to say that they've done a tremendous, tremendous job, and I'm very proud of them. Even though they're not in my district, in my area, they're still part of Salinas, and that's what I represent. And I just want to thank them all for really coming together and doing it. And I must say, the hospital did say 100%, and if anybody came into it afterwards, they would have to pay it themselves. I've been there, unless I haven't been phone, you know, didn't get a phone call for one of their meetings, but most of the time I get a phone call from one of the community to let me know if they're having a meeting. So anyway, they've done a tremendous job.
Thank you, Marianne. Okay. All right. Well, there you go. That's the last word. All right, back to council. Let's see. Let me just choose. I think a couple. A couple of the questions that were raised, I don't think we can get at all of them. But between James, Kelly, or Gary, was there anything there that we can weigh in on, and for instance, why somebody wouldn't be doing enforcement on Friday? Kelly, I think you addressed your thoughts on civilian patrols in terms of your concerns, but how might they work? I'll let staff just kind of pick up on. And then I think the one I hear pretty clearly is why for lack of a better word, gross underestimation of, it sounds a little bit to me like the Solid Waste Authority. The better you get at promoting recycling, your revenues go down and you get caught. But how would you categorize, how come we were so far off? Not that would be James or Gary.
Oh, good, thanks.
Feel free.
I do believe that it does. You know, that the whole idea of enforcement being so effective as to make the program more expensive is telling. I think that really does describe generally what you can do with more resources, and I don't think that's a shock to anyone. If we have people that could, if we could dedicate that kind of concentrated parking enforcement to the area around Hartnell and the area around wherever the parking is a problem, then we'll mitigate the problem. The same is true for law enforcement generally. I cannot answer the question about the Furlough Friday thing. I just don't know the answer. I don't know if they, even though they're funded by Memorial Hospital, if they fall subject to the city rules. I'm sorry, I'm just not informed and prepared to answer that question, but I can certainly find out.
Okay.
And with regard to the civilian patrols, I don't mean to say that, and I think the point that particular neighborhood has a low crime rate because the citizens are engaged is accurate. And nothing I said here tonight should be taken to mean you shouldn't be out there, because you absolutely should. I'm just concerned with direct action. Absolutely go out there and see and observe and be seen making those observations. Don't be afraid to pick up the phone and call. If it's not an emergency, if you're reporting a parking problem, we'll take that on a priority basis. 758-7321 is the non-emergency number, and that will get queued, and as resources become available, we'll address your parking issue. Again, understanding that if it's not dedicated to that area, you're competing with the rest of the city for those resources, but we'll get to it. I'm just concerned about the direct action by citizens.
Okay, Gary.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. I came to this party a little late. I inherited this project, but what I've studied it very carefully, and I want to go to the issue of parking. This is very important, and I think we're hearing how important this program is to the neighbors, and we need to figure out how to make it work. And part of this goes to the parking garage. There are issues with parking throughout the city, and I believe that one of the ways we need to look at this is to take on a more global look at all of our parking issues and understand how it works with enforcement, how we pay for our parking programs, and how we all make all of them work for the benefit of the city. So that's one piece. There were faulty assumptions that were made, and there were errors that were made in this number. We're doing a program that had never been done. There were mistakes that were made in calculations that led to faulty assumptions that led to bad outcomes. No question. It's a program that needs to be tightly managed. It's a program that needs to be adjusted and move forward. As I said, I came late to the party, as did Mr. Pressy. Come late to the party, and we've both looked at this program inside and out, and I think that you're going to see as we go forward that we will work these numbers on a month-to-month basis. We will understand how it works, and that we will come back to you with adjustments as we go forward so that we can give this neighborhood what they need. I also believe that Mr. Sargente's point about engaging the neighbors and the process of communicating with our constituents is really important, and that's part of managing this program. So it's like we go forward with this in the next year. This ties to the larger parking issue throughout the city, which is an issue that is public works now joined together so that the parking and the people who enforce the parking and the people who deal with the administrative piece are all under one roof. We have a different way of looking at this, and we need to put that to work. We need to put management to work. We need to make this program work, and we need to prepare ourselves to apply this in other areas of the city where people need this relief. So that's what I have to say about it. Mistakes were made, but we're going to move past that, and we're going to get it right.
Okay. Thanks, Gary. Okay, with that, I'm going to go ahead and proceed to council comments before we get started. To my right, Councilmember Barrera.
Well, I would like to concur with Mr. Peterson on Mr. Sargenti's comment. I think when you take ownership of your neighborhoods, which it looks like it's happening, we're seeing some positive coming out of this. And of course, with every project that we haven't ventured through this issue, thanks to Ms. Serrano and his patience and all his good work, I think we're up to a good start. Now, for those of you that are not happy and you want to continue coming back, we enjoy company here at City Hall. But I think you need to look at the glass half full instead of half empty, because like anything else, nothing's perfect. But if it's working, let's get those things that are working, whether it's getting more people involved in bettering this community, it sounds, what I hear, it sounds like there's a lot of things working. And yeah, we just have to tweak this thing. And I think we got some really good leadership here with Mr. Peterson and Mr. Pressy. And I think we're going to resolve this issue where you're going to be hopefully satisfied. So congratulations, staff, for a good work.
Okay, thank you, Tony. Anyone else to my right? Gloria?
Well, thank you, Mr. Serrano and Mr. Peterson. I kind of had mixed feelings about all this. And I can understand the community, how you must feel, because we need to engage, just like Mr. Peterson just said. We need to continue to engage them, James, and to try to find that solution. There's neighborhoods where it's a big problem, not just your neighborhood, but within the rest of the city. But I have to say that the medical offices, the woman that said about the medical offices, I think we need to look at that too, Mr. Serrano, because you just don't have the hospital, and you know, you have also all those medical office, you know, the employees, and it's just a big problem. But yeah, we should have looked at this years ago. I always said I can't believe we never looked at two-tier parking, you know. But we're here, and I think we need to work together and to try to find a solution. But again, I support that we continue to have the dialogue with the community.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Jill.
Well, at this point, what I'd like to do is I want to make some comments, and then I hope that we can look to Councilmember McShane to kind of, after everyone's commented, to see what he would suggest. It is his district. I am supportive of preferential permit parking districts, and it does make sense. It certainly makes sense in this neighborhood, but the program absolutely has to be self-supporting. I was concerned about the $40,000 deficit that I saw from last year, first year. That seems to be something we're working out. But I think that we all have to be aware too that we're looking at, we tonight, just before this item, we passed an MOU which really amounted to nearly $2 million of dollars in employee concessions. I can tell this council right now that next week there's going to be a group from my district that's going to come forward with a petition for permit parking. And so James, that's the Plaza Park Apartments. Just to let you know that we're opening up a Pandora's box, and I want to address that in just a minute. But Kim Lee, if because your district used to be part of my district, and after this and then the problem in my district happens, I can tell you the next group is going to be Boronda Manor that's going to be coming to you.
And Iris off of the Rodeo as well.
Oh, that's right. Rodeo You've got grounds. A couple of problems. Okay. And so as we're looking at really the infrastructure of the city, the streets, the sidewalks, the gutters, we can look at, you know, a 10-year waiting list on getting sidewalk repairs. I had a woman call me yesterday who said, you know, my sidewalk is so bad, the city's going to end up paying millions of dollars in liabilities, perhaps an exaggeration, but nonetheless a big concern. I want to say quickly, I really appreciate the especially the women who came up and talked. I mean, not no offense to the men, but the women that came up and talked that were so conciliatory and said, you know, we'd be willing to pay extra for the permits. I appreciate that kind of going a step further and really trying to work this out, because I'll be honest with you, some of the emails that we got, I found offensive and absolutely unacceptable in terms of really resorting to calling our staff unprofessional and a number of other things, and it was in my mind not the way to deal with a city issue. Having said that, you know, when we look at what the costs will be, if we look at this second year program, we're probably looking at a $2,000 plus or negative, and that's really negligible. And I think even if we did an entire program for the entire city, if we're just looking at that small amount of money, it's not an issue. If it's going to be significantly more, then we're going to be in a world of hurt, because if we're going to commit to your district, Steve, then you better commit to my district, and then I better commit to Kimberly's district, two areas in her district. I almost, and Steve, I'll be eager to hear what you have to say, but I'm almost wondering if this might be a time for us to think about developing, because we did hear concerns saying from some of the neighbors saying, you know, that we weren't really a part of the process. And I think, Matt, you brought up the fact that there are questions that haven't been answered, and those are very legitimate concerns. If it might be good idea to set up a subcommittee to work with these neighbors, work with the people who are going to bring the petition next week from my district, that we have a preferential permit parking district program, so that we can apply it citywide, so that when Boronda Manor, when the Rodeo comes, when my group comes, we'll be able to have this city policy. That will hopefully not be a drain on the city resources. Because I know I'm very concerned. James has been spending a lot of time with this program, or with this issue, and there's a lot of problems that have been going on recently in my district that I'm concerned about. People, someone called me yesterday about the corner of Pescadero and Emerald, a lot of problems with parking, street parking, and drug dealing going on. So that's got to be dealt with, and I'll talk to you about that later, Kelly. But so anyway, that would be my thought at this point, would be to perhaps set up a subcommittee, obviously with the mayor's and Steve's approval, and we get this neighborhood, the Maple Park neighborhood, and we get the Park Plaza apartments together and see if we can form some kind of city policy, so that with a preferential parking permit program, it would be successful regardless of where it's put into place. But I am very sympathetic. I understand. I appreciated, you know, the comments that came to us that said, you know, our street is now livable. We have relief. And I one time lived in a neighborhood that had permit parking, a preferential permit parking program, and it really made all the difference between living in a livable neighborhood and living in a very difficult neighborhood. So having said that, I think that's all my comments for now.